has that song? Anchors Away, that's a Navy song. Anybody here from Navy? Nobody? I gotta behave myself, huh?
If I were a young person, a young man or woman or school, and I can think back to my formative days, so to speak, where people came to my school or I got to meet them, and they made an impression on my life. So I would hope that during these daily presentations here at the Kennedy Space Center that I can make an impact on some youngster's life. So that, to me, is the most important reason for doing this.
78, they picked the first class of space shuttle astronauts, and I was fortunate, I'll use the word blessed, to be included in such a distinguished group of people. I'm way over there on the left in the front row. Brand new polyester suit back in 1978. Cowboy boots since I've been living in Texas. It was a great group of people, 35 of us. And 15 of us were the traditional pilot types. I came from the Navy.
How important do you view the astronaut encounter in maintaining that connection with the public? Now that they may not see astronauts that fly from Kennedy, we don't know for how long. So do you really view that as like an important link to maintain that connection with the public?
I certainly do. No matter which course we take here in the next 6 or 8 months as Congress mulls over this space budget, and the administration and Congress are working together to see what direction we take, I think it's very important that those of us who've been there and done it continue what we have done and what we are doing. That's to, like you and I have talked, to inspire the youngsters to, you know, these kids that I'm talking to today, one of them could be the first person to walk on Mars if and when we go there. So I'd love to think that if I'm still around in 20 years, I'll be able to shake the hand of that man or woman who was down here and maybe listened to me and said thank you for back in the year 2010 for convincing me I can do this, and now I'm on my way and I want to thank you. I'd love to get a phone call or a handshake like that one of these days.
Between these two, so you know how easy that is? Coming down like a rock, about 330 miles an hour coming right into the runway. This is telling me to start pulling my nose up when this gets here, so then before I get there, I'll start pulling my nose up to slow my rate of descent. I'll land right down here on this runway. We're at 1,000 feet, 310 knots right now. I want to cross into the runway 15 feet. The landing gear coming down, right over in the runway. Touchdown right on this line, 2,500 feet down the runway. Just like that. Remember, we travel around the Earth every hour and a half, so that final portion of the landing, we travel 14,000 miles in 1 hour. We slow down over Australia to make the final approach here at Kennedy. It's just amazing to me that we can do this time after time after time. No engines, just a big glider, and we'll touch down at about 15 or 20 feet of this line, just about every time.
20 years ago, I came to his junior high school and talked to his class, and he wasn't interested too much in science, but he turned it all around, got interested in school, not only science, but school, and now is a PhD working for Johns Hopkins up in Baltimore. So those are the kind of things that really make you feel good.